into this particular video, I'll be discussing it with you about the key sections of your robot framework. So let's get started up here very quickly. The agenda which we're going to follow up here for today is your settings followed by keywords, variables, test cases and tags. This is all what we will be discussing up into this particular video. Now let me take you towards the detailed explanation of each and every topic, and that's so with the practical implementation. Here goes your very first one, that is your settings. Now this is one of the type of a section which actually contains, if you have to import up any statement for any particular library, so yes, you can do that under the settings section. If you require up any resources, the setup is done into that option, and even you can use up the tear down commands. So these are some of the respective things which are really very I would say the important ones onto your settings thing, right? So importing library, your resources, the setup of your, the tear down commands. So those all comes under your settings section only. Now I will take you towards my PyCharm IDE, and there I'll show you that how you can make up this settings section over their IDE. So I will just take you over the one. Okay, great. So here we are onto my PyCharm IDE. The installation part is already covered onto my previous video, so you can just go there and watch it out. Now I can make up a new project over here for my settings things file, the new project. Okay, I can give it a project of searching, let's say, and create it. I'm gonna attach it up over here. Right, here it is. Now inside that, I can make up a new file. I will go with the file option, right? Now, into this file option, I will be putting up the name of my file. So let's say it is one, okay, dot. Now here you have to put in the extension of the robot file to make this as a robot one. So one dot robot and hit out enter. Now see, you will see a special type of a symbol which is being made up over here. And with that, you can recognize that yes, your robot file has successfully been made. Okay, if this particular symbol is not appearing up over your screen, so you have to go over the settings and click over this, go over the file, click on the settings option and install up a plugin which is your IntelliBot plugin. Okay, so I would just write up over here as well, IntelliBot plugin. Okay, and if you will install this IntelliBot plugin onto your PyCharm, it will work out fine. Now I'll show you that how we can make up the settings section. So you have to use in three stars over here, right, given a space and start writing settings. See the first option you get in, click over there. And here is your, one second, yes. This is how you make up your key section for the settings, right? That is the respective method about making up the settings over here. Right, now let's say I want the Selenium library to put down over here. So I can write it up in such a manner, like a library. And let's say that is my Selenium library, right? Like that, I can simply write it up over here, right? So into this particular manner, you can just put up the things for now. I'm not gonna put it up over here. I'm gonna remove it for now. We'll be doing up these things in a very short while. Maybe onto the next video. So that's the manner how you can do up the things right now. That's not the correct place where I am writing. That was the reason for showing me that red mark. So this is the how you can put up this particular settings option over here. Right. Now, this particular key section is being done. That is your settings key section. Inside that, you will be writing up in the start same manner as I told you, now that library. And inside that, we'll be writing Selenium, right? Selenium, let's say library, right? Now it's working absolutely okay. So your library is your Selenium library. Down that, we can put up over resource like this over here, whatsoever is. So that is the manner how you just do up these particular settings. Fine. Great. So this is the settings key section. Now I'll take you back to my presentation and they will be discussing up the next type of our key section that we have up over here is your keywords, right? So whenever you want to execute up the test and things like that, so keyword is one of the key section which will contain all the operations which are used for executing up your test, right? Now there are different types of keywords taking in your built-in keywords, your library keywords, your user-defined keywords. So in the next video of this particular one series only, I'll be explaining you all these three types of the different keywords into the detail. But yeah, as from the name suggests, built-in keywords are the ones who are already there. User-defined keywords are the ones which you will be making onto your own library. Keywords are the ones which are there into some of the libraries, right? So that is what is a brief intro about your different keywords. Now I'll show you how you can make up the keywords key section as well. So again, it's the same. You just have to put these three ones, and here you have to write in up like keywords, right? And into the starting, you can remove it up, and that's how you make up your keywords section, right? So it's very simple about making up all of these particular sections over. So into this part inside the keyword, you will be writing all the stuff, which will be including up your execution, and it will be including up your keywords. It can be your user defined or built-in or library keywords. That's your choice based upon the how you are using up the test keys and the things like that, right? So this is your keywords key section. Now after this keywords key section, what we can do, what we cannot do, I'm going to take you with the variables one. Now this is a sort of a section which contains up your keywords arguments and your global and local values, right? So here, if you want to change in the test data in some location, right, if you're having one location where your test data is actually saved and you want to change that, so there the variables help you to do that same thing into a easier manner. So here, variable section which we are having, it actually contains up your keyword arguments and your global and local values. So whatsoever the keywords we did used in the arguments for all of those are contained up over here, and even you can give in the local and the global values are also put up over inside your variables key section, right? I'm going to take you back to my PyCharm IDE and discuss this variables section. Again, I'm going to put three stars over there and write about variables, and this one I will remove it from here. Right, so this is the manner how you create in that variables section. Now inside this, you can using your keyword arguments, you can write your keyword arguments inside this, and next you can write up your global and local values inside your variables key section, right? Next, I'll again take you back to my PPT, and next we are having up the test cases. Now this is the section. It explains by the name itself that what will it be actually about. So yes, it is completely about your test cases. So this is the section which contains up the test cases which you will be writing, which you will be executing. So there are two different common approaches for writing up your test cases: keyword driven and the Gherkin. Both of these I will be discussing up into the detail into my further series of the same videos, but for now you have to understand only this much, that under your key test cases section, you just simply write in the test cases inside that. And two approaches for writing up the test cases is the keyword driven and the Gherkin, right? So I'm going to take you through, and once I will show you that as well, how you can put that. By the time I know, you already now know that how you can put that. But yeah, let me give you an idea once over here. And it's gonna be like the test cases, okay? And I'm gonna remove it up from here. So yes, that's how you can put up these respective all of the key sections over here onto your PyCharm IDE, and that's the method. Now I'll take you one more over here, and we have one more key section, and that is your tags. Now tags are used in for classifying up your test cases, right? So what are the test cases we are having? What are the test case sections we have? Different sections for the test cases we are having. So tags helps them to put up all of those onto the brackets, right? So whatever tags we have in into the test case section, those are put up inside the brackets. So from like without any of the things itself, you will be able to understand that, okay, this is the place where your tags have been written. So always we write the test tags inside your test cases only. So right away, I just explained you that how you can make up that particular test case section, right? Now into that particular test case section only, you will be writing up your tags. So I would just once take you over here, and inside this only, you will be writing up your tags, right? Like this, the same manner which I had put in the large brackets. And inside that, you will be able to put up your tags over there, whatsoever are the required ones. And the large brackets are the ones which will help you to define and even to denote that, okay, these are my tags, right? So I hope I am pretty much clear to you with these settings, keywords, variables, test cases, and tags. With all of these five of the key sections which we have up over here into the robot framework, when to use, what to use, and which one is to be used out where. I hope I'm clear with this. Into the next video, I'll be taking you towards the file extensions, file resources, and your keywords over there. Right, so hope you had gotten the idea. For more, you can go on to LangaTest official website. Check out there, there's a lot of amazing stuff we have in, and you can even read out the LangaTest blogs. The link for both of these are mentioned in the description box. So thank you, take care, and see you in the next video.